Okay, so Blender 4.0 has just been released, and I'm actually on Blender 4.1 alpha, but that's not that important. Because of the new release, I decided, okay, it's time to finally make an official release of the math formula add-on, since the last release was from Blender 2.93. So how do you do this? How does it work? You either go to geometry nodes or the shading nodes. So let's just go to geometry nodes for now, and I'll create a new node tree. I'll press Control space to make this full screen, and you press Alt F, and that will give you this prompt. And there you can start typing a formula like 4 × 8 + 7. And press Control Enter to confirm, and it adds exactly that formula. Now, something a bit more complicated is using some geometry node specific nodes. You can, for example, go Scene Time. So I press Tab to auto complete Scene Time, and I can press Tab again to get the two possible outputs, so either frame or seconds. So if I press keep pressing Tab, it will cycle through the options. So in this case, I want the frame, and by default, the frame is from 1 to 250, I think, which is not that useful. Or usually you want it in a, maybe a nicer range, like from minus 1 to 1, so you could do something like this. This is just a simple example of how you could use this add-on. Now, the idea is not that you're going to create your whole node tree for the add-on, although in principle you can. The idea is more that you add small components of the node tree using this add-on. So, for example, I can create a grid with the add-on. I could also do that with Shift-A. Maybe in this case, I will use the link drag search functionality built into Blender. And then I want to do something with the offset. Now for this, I'm going to use my add-on to create a formula. And maybe I want to create some sort of wavy pattern. So to do that, I'm going to need the X and Y coordinates of the position. But probably it will work better if I scale it, and then I'll add a sign into it so that we get a wavy pattern. And then I just need a vector to put into the offset. I need a vector which has X times Y, for example, in the Z component. Okay, you can just do that and plug that into there. So see, you don't necessarily need to create the whole setup with the add-on, but you could in principle. So all nodes are in there. So if I press rotate and I look to complete, you can see all these nodes. So for example, rotate Euler local, press Control Enter. It will create a rotate Euler node with the Euler and local mode set. So you could, in principle, create everything with the add-on, but that's maybe not the quickest way to do things. Now, if you notice that there's some node in there that's not in your version of Blender, what you do is you can go to press N to go to the N panel. And here on the side, you have the math formula tab. And there's this button that says regenerate node info. So if I press that, what that does is it essentially in the background adds all the nodes that this version of Blender knows about. It queries the Python API in the background, and then it checks what are the possible inputs and outputs depending on which modes I said. And then it stores that somewhere that the file that the add-on can use. And this way you're sure that the nodes that the add-on knows about correspond to the nodes that Blender knows about in that specific version. So that's something you can do. So I would suggest pressing this once you install the add-on. And then right above, you have this thing about custom implementations. And that's essentially something like this. Sometimes you want to, or you're constantly reusing certain function or formulas. And instead, so what you would do is then create a node group. Well, you have the same sort of thing. You can create a in node group, but inside the add-on itself. So for example, the SDF of a capsule, I don't memorize the formula, but it would be useful to have it. So I can press SD and then tab to autocomplete. For example, you see that SD box, sphere, rhombus, and capsule, these are all the add-on knows about these functions. I already wrote the code for this function once, and I stored it somewhere in a file, which I'll explain later how that works. And then I can just call it So Control Enter to confirm, and it adds this, and you can see that this node group contains the formula for the SDF of a capsule. So how do you create these things on your own? Well, one thing you can do is you can create your own functions or node groups right inside Blender like this. So for example, this is a function which just adds a grid. Now, this just defines the function. If I want to call it, I should call it myself. And you can see that it creates a grid. But maybe the next time you open Blender, then that function won't be there anymore. It will only be remembered for this session. So if you want to create this more permanently, what you can do is you go to your Edit Preferences, you go to the Add-on Preferences, so Math Formula, and then there's a bunch of options here to change things like the highlighting and some key maps that you can change. But for us, the important part here is this folder, and these are where all the custom implementations are stored. So if I click on this, you can see there's three files, and you can ignore these cache files. These are just things the add-on uses to load it quicker. So for example, if I go to this one, you can see that here is, for example, the definition of what SD capsule is. And it starts with ng for node group. And that means that when it's called, it will create a node group with these parameters and this output. Now you can read more about the specifics on how to create this in the wiki, and this link to in the release notes as well. So if I go here, then you get this page. There's a quick start guide on how to create a basic formula, and then some more detailed explanation about the syntax, about custom implementations, and about the key bytes. So I hope you find this add-on useful. If you liked it, let me know. I'm always interested to see if people actually use this add-on, and if you have any feedback or problems you encountered, you can leave an issue on the GitHub page or just in the comments of the YouTube video if that's easier for you.